It's time for reinforcements.
So, how did Anne get... How did... Let's just forget about that, okay. Let him pass. Sure, oh look, he has a stand. Right? What was the glory thing? Maybe the car itself is a stand? I let you pass. Now hurry up and go already. He's probably angry about your maneuver, and these are the consequences. So, did you get a look at the driver's face? No. The windows were covered in thick dust. Couldn't see a thing. Neither could I. Could be. Be very careful, Polnareff. Oh. Now he wants me to pass. Looks like the fools realized how shitty that piece of junk is. You should have stayed behind me in the first place, dumbass. Thought it through. Wait, where the hell did that truck come from? Wow. If it went for Star Platinum's power, we would have been crushed beneath them like a tin can. He's gone. Where did that plastic car go? Looks like it just kept going. I think the driver could have been one of the stand users. Then again, could have just been some sick. No, yeah. We were almost roadkill for God's sake. Then why didn't he simply... I like how they're not checking on the truck driver. I like how they're not checking on the... What should we do about that truck? Star Platinum left it a wreck. Won't be going anywhere. That's easy. Pretend we never saw it. Let's get going. How is that even cool? You just murdered someone! You just did a hit and run! Are you kidding me? Are you... A roadside D-stand. What is this? Freaking Roadrunner and Coyote? Wow, that is like one of the most fucked up things I've ever seen in anime. What is that stuff? Fresh sugar cane juice. Care for a glass? Sure, why not? Hmm? What? It's him! That car's here! I gotta start writing these moments so I can do like top 10 anime moments. Hey, tell me something! Who's the owner of that car over there? Come on! This reminds me of that Stephen King movie where, like, the trucks come alive. Be it that these are not trucks, you know, same thing. No way. Where, like, the cars attack people. But it was more trucks. So.
Instead of just brute strength. Not
not bad, Kakuyin. Got a question for you. You like sumo?
You like sumo? What? What?
Yeah, I'm a fan of sumo, but in sumo, it's against the rules to punch your opponent. Nothing here suggests he used the stand attack. I think it's safe to say he's just some weirdo with an axe to grind. Yeah, either way, he's a goner.
He's a goner? The Wheel of Fortune, huh?
I've got a bad feeling. Everybody get in the car. No, stay back. Don't go anywhere near it. Couldn't be. Below us.
Oh, goodbye, car. Wait, what is, Wait, the truck came... what did I call it? The truck? The car came back?
Looks like the stand's user is inside the car.
Oh.
What the?
It's a transformer.
Now what is it doing?
Dude. The Wheel of Fortune.
Be the tool you want. I'm happy to oblige. Don't do it, Jotaro. Don't fight it yet. Not until we know what that stand's power is.
Oh.
Jotaro! Impossible. I couldn't see it. What the hell did he shoot at me? How the hell did he...
Don't even know what hit you, eh? You'll soon find out. The moment you corrupt, that is.
What is that? Stars? Wow. Okay.
Okay.
Little girl, sure, important. Truck driver, nah, fuck him. He don't have a family. I'm offended. Oh no! What the hell was that? So that's what he did?
That's what he was shooting. Gasoline. It was shooting small amounts of it at high speed, like bullets. Incredible. This is nuts. So he wasn't trying to wound us. He was dousing our bodies with gasoline. We're covered in this stuff. Looks like you finally caught on, but it's too late now. Now all you need is a little jolt.
Wow. Holy shit. Wait, he went underground?
Let me guess, you thought it'd be you, you roadhog.
You burrowed into the ground with dark plastic! So the only thing that burned up was your jacket!
A little parting wisdom. What you said earlier about paths was dead wrong. You see, in life, you have to forge your own path. No one can do it for you, so I'll offer you some guidance. But first, you have to go through a little pain.
I just want to know how the car is just floating in the air like that.
That is how it's done. See, you just paved your own path. Congrats on being a fast learner. Here ends the lesson.
What? Oh, he... Do you even lift, bro? Wow, they're just laughing at him. I thought she was dead. Alright, I like what just happened there. They got rid of Anne again. But I love what Anne just said. That life is full of goodbyes. It makes it seem so sad. Just true. It would have been cool if he got a different jacket, but he got the same one again. It's one hell of a drop off the right side, and there's no guardrail anywhere. The fog looks even thicker up ahead. It's not even 3 o'clock yet, but we should head in. Let's find a place to stay in that town for the night. You think they have nice hotels? That's a weird looking town. Better have a decent bathroom. I just couldn't get used to the really strange toilets they have all over India and the Middle East. Oh. I didn't even get... what?
Hey, this is a nice little town, don't you think? There must be at least a few thousand people living here. Let's ask about a hotel at that restaurant over there. But there's a weird quiet about this place. No matter where we've gone, every other place has been rowdy and congested. It's probably because of the fog. Listen up, guys. In Pakistan and the rest of the Islamic world, this is how you greet people. First you smile and say, As-salam alaykum.
And his clothes. Wow, shut down.
No harm intended. No need to close up shop just for us, sir. We just wanted to ask a question. Are there any hotels here in town? Anybody home? I do not know. Hey, wait a minute. What do you mean you don't know?
Oh, what's with the insects? Oh, are they like hallucinating bugs and stuff?
I must have imagined it. I'm sure he couldn't understand you because your pronunciation's so bad. Let's just go ask that guy over there. Excuse me, sorry, but we're looking for a hotel around here. Preferably a hotel with nice clean bathrooms. Do you know any of that?
Well, he did.
Whoa, hey you, what's wrong?
Oh.
Pardon me, young man. My boil seemed to be festering today. My apologies.
I think the first thing I would want to do is get the fuck out of town. I'm out of here. No. Get out of here. Get out of town. Look, what the hell is she even talking about? What is she talking about?
There's a man lying dead in the street. Nobody seems even the slightest bit concerned. Shh. Didn't they hear the gunshot? Nobody's doing anything. It's like they don't even care. These people are more oblivious than the most jaded New Yorker or Tokyoite. That dog.
This blasted. Oh, what are they, ghosts?
The fog is swallowing the town whole. This is really creepy. Call me crazy, but doesn't that part there look like a skull?
Oh.
Someone who's after us kill a man who has nothing to do with us before we even got here. There's no reason for a stand user to kill him. Who knows? The way he died is obviously unnatural. Let's examine the body before the police come. Just try not to touch it. Right. This might be something. It appears he was traveling too, just like us. He has bus and train tickets in his pocket. And he looks like he might be Indian. He's carrying Indian money on him. I'm guessing he's not from this town. Oh. Look at this wound. He's got a gaping hole here right in his upper chest. This must be what killed him. Hang on. Why isn't there any blood coming out? With a fatal chest wound this big, there should be blood gushing everywhere. Unless, of course, this is no ordinary murder. Looks like things are about to get messy. We've got to get to the bottom of this. It's time to search him. Take off his clothes.
There
are tons of holes all over this guy. He's like that cartoon cheese you see on Tom and Jerry. There's not probably blood anywhere near those wounds. How on earth was this man killed? What does all of this mean? Be careful. There wasn't a stand user here before. You can bet there's one here now.
Oh, what the f- I mean, why did you want to hop into the car like that?
Hey, old man, what in the hell are you doing? You're crazy.
Yeah.
Oh, no! What do you mean, what am I doing? The car was right here just a minute ago! Huh? What are you talking about? We just parked the car over there and walked. What? But just now I could have sworn that-
Oh. Here's the old lady.
Well, hello, good sirs. I see you are travelers. I'm afraid with this fog, it's dangerous to leave the town now. There aren't any cliffs, you know. I run my own bed and breakfast not far from here. If you'd like, why not stay there for the night? There's plenty of room for everyone. I'll even give you a healthy discount.
Finally, we've actually met a normal person for once.
Laughs in irony. Oh, that's so funny.
Come on, this way, Master Joestar. That building over there is my bed and breakfast. Follow me and I'll show you to your rooms. Try not to fall behind. I know it doesn't look like much, but it has history. About 20 years ago, one of the 007 movies was still here.
What?
Would you prefer me? If not, we have fresh fish available.
Wait a second, Grandma. Before, you called me Joestar, didn't you?
Come now, that delightful young man next to you said Mr. Joestar earlier. I made the old but my ears still work.
You mean me? I think I said it, but I'm not sure.
Ah, you did, sir. When you've been working in this business for as many years as I have, you really learn to memorize people's names quickly. So I'm sure of it.
By the way, ma'am, I just noticed the bandages. What happened to your hand?
This? A minor burn, nothing more. I suppose it's just my old age, but I accidentally spilled boiling water on it.
Oh, don't be silly, madame. You hardly look a day over 40, and that's God's honest truth. What do you say you and I get dinner alone?
Is she that desperate Oh, my God. Oh, touche, yeah. Wow.
Well then, allow me to show you to your rooms, gentlemen.
Man, talk about a weird town. Now, time to hit the loo. I don't think it's functional.
If that's the case, I won't be able to use Hermit Purple to get info on the enemy.
Hey, Mr. Joestar, what's the matter?
Yeah. A stand user could attack at any moment. Such an idiot. Oh, look, the sharpshooter guy. Hard horse thingy. Thick as thieves.
So you were close?
Yeah, we were practically brothers. He was a dear friend and an excellent partner. What's this all about? You weren't acting like yourself at all, Yama.
His death must weigh heavily on you. Will you avenge him? Is that why you're here?
Yes, that's exactly it. I'm gonna make sure those bastards pay for killing my best friend.
That's exactly what I want to hear! No! I'm going to kill you so you'll feel betrayal!
No! Hey, Yama, what the hell are you doing? No!
Wow! The betrayal. Wow. And then... He talks like a Scooby-Doo character.
Is something wrong, Polder F, huh?
What was that noise?
Same here. I was about to check downstairs. I'll look in the lobby first. Call me if you find anything, okay?
Wow. I love how the character's like, you know what? Let him figure it out. If he doesn't come back, then he did. I love that. I love that. I like how Jotaro's like, yeah. I it's pretty damn obvious something doesn't feel right. Oh, John Pierre, you're gonna go. You're gonna. Okay, go ahead. Hey guys, hold up. He gonna die. He gonna die. All right. So you got Jabba. What's her name? I didn't expect hard horse, whatever the hell his name was. I didn't expect him to literally bite the bullet. You know, but. He did, too. This old lady's so particular with her powers as well, so... I really don't know how they're gonna stop her, too. And my other questions would be, where the hell does the show go from here? You fight the old little lady, and that's it. Dio doesn't have any more henchmen, as, you know, for the meantime, I guess. And where the hell could the show go from there, you know? What a bizarre adventure the show is. So all right, that about wraps up my video. Thanks so much for watching. God bless you, and I'll see you soon. Bye bye.